wobbly. So we've got, this is, well, I don't really know myself, but I can't remember the name of it. But my friend, a good friend at Kent Bearings, told me that you remove these two screws, then you screw one into here and it will force it out. Tighten this up so I can see it's coming out. Cool. So we've got two halves with thread, partial thread on there. So you can see how that works. So the shaft has bent. Crikey. There, we can see that. I've got the tag on this side. Got a lot of grime in here. And there's the two nuts that fell in. So much. Well, it looks like sawdust. Yeah, definitely needs doing this. Okay. I think this is going to be a struggle to remove because it's bent. Oh, I see that. Yeah, there it goes. That's the centrifugal part. So as it spins around, these go outwards and disengage the power from the capacitor, the starting capacitor. Don't break anything, don't break anything. God, this thing's huge. I'm trying to give birth. It's a boy! Oh. Whew. Some packing washers on there, don't lose them. Whew. There it goes. No bearings, it just uses a bronze bush. It's got, you can see there's a wick in there. capacitor. It's a big ass capacitor. I've already pre-placed some of the wiring there. God, it's heavy. Here we go. Sort of snorts when you switch it off and then slows down rapidly. Interesting that the lights dim as it goes on. There it goes. And then it slows right down. Strange. Input shaft seems smooth. Cool. The motor is done.